okay, intermolecular force of attraction, okay, intermolecular
yes, sir.
Attraction, there is a polar interaction, there is a non polar interaction, okay. Intermolecular force of attraction, there is two types of intermolecular force of attraction. One is polar interaction, another is non polar interaction, okay. Polar means molecule will be polar, that means there is a separation of charge, okay. So polar interaction means higher charges are involved, okay. Polar interaction means higher charge is involved. It is further classified into, dekho, dipole dipole interaction. One is dipole dipole interaction, another is dipole induced dipole interaction. Dipole dipole means there is a pole in between two molecules, okay. But dipole induced dipole, that's mean there is a dipole molecule, there is a polar molecules, and if another is in non polar molecules, but in presence of polar molecule, some non polar molecule will be polar, okay. Jemon ki hocche, jemon orithike kacha kachi theke theke ha amader srijit peke jacche, bujhla to nosto hoye jacche.
O tai
induce hocche bujhle, arthat orithik jodi polar hoy tahole amader srijit ki induce polar, tai to mane डेल्टा प्लस डेल्टा माइनस इज देयर, ओके, दिस इज पोलर मॉलिक्यूल. Clear? So dipole, there is a dipole, and if there is a ion dipole, that's mean if like water, if it is delta minus, if there is a Na plus Cl minus, then this is ion and this is pole. So there is a interaction. So it is ion and dipole interaction like this. Okay. So ion dipole interaction. Now non polar interaction, where charges are not involved, non polar interaction, because in non polar molecules there is no charge, okay. So where charges are not involved, this is known as non polar interaction. So dispersed force, that's mean induced dipole interaction, that's mean there is a two interaction, that's mean induced dipole between the force between actually ki induced dipole means ebar jodi dekha jay orithike kache kache theke amader ayusho polar hoye geche ar srijito polar hoye geche, tar mane ebar srijit ebong ayush mile ebare aro badmashi korche, tar mane eta ki hocche induced, tai to?
Yes sir.
Orithike?
Yes sir.
Since the electronegativity difference is high between hydrogen and fluorine, then due to the electronegativity, the bonded electron of HF remains in the side of fluorine actually, okay. So F has tendency to attract the bonded electron towards itself, okay. For this reason, if movement of the electron is occurred, then there will be a pole, okay, like this, okay, like this, then it will be delta minus and it is delta plus, okay. So delta is actually slight or partial charge, okay, on H plus and F minus. So charge molecule is polar molecule. All charge molecule is known as actually polar molecule. So if HF is a polar molecule, if it is continuously it's completely separate, then it will be ionic. But it is not ionic, it is polar, because it is completely not H plus and completely not in F minus. If it is in aqueous solution, if HF dissolve in water, then it will be completely dissociate into ions. Okay, so HF is a polar molecule. Is it okay? So polar covalent bond, this bond is also known as polar covalent bond. Clear? HF bond is polar covalent bond, HCl bond is polar covalent bond. Okay, so two charges involved for the attraction. So this is the polar covalent bond. Okay, this is the polar covalent bond, and negative charge on the side of electronegative element. Okay, so electron density is more towards the electronegative element. Hence, opposite poles attract and align themselves. How? Like this. Plus minus plus minus plus minus. That's it. H plus F minus, H plus F minus, H plus F minus. So this is known as hydrogen bond. Okay, this is known as hydrogen bond. Clear? Okay, this dot 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 is known as hydrogen bond, because between hydrogen delta plus and F delta minus, there is a attraction, force of attraction. It is also van der Waals force also. Okay, that's mean actually dipole-dipole interaction. So this is known as hydrogen bond. So dipole-dipole interaction, the electrostatic force of attraction between neighboring molecule having permanent dipole moment. Okay, the electrostatic force of attraction between neighboring molecule having permanent dipole moment. Clear? How do we calculate the dipole moment of any molecule? How do we calculate? If it is delta plus and delta minus, then the dipole moment mu equal to charge into separation distance between these two dipole. Okay, if charge is delta minus or delta plus, anything, it is known as q. Okay, this is q into distance between these two pole. Distance between these two pole, this is the distance. It is l by denoted by this. Okay, so mu is the dipole moment. So how we can calculate the dipole moment of any molecule? For any polar molecule, the dipole moment mu equal to charge of any pole into distance between these two pole. Okay, clear? So note, dipole interaction energy between stationary polar molecule is proportional to 1 by r to the power 3. Eta note kore rakho, eta exam e dao, thik ache? Ei je value ta mone rakhte hobe, kar shonge proportional? Jokhon dipole dipole hobe, tokhon jokhon energy ar ki dipole dipole energy interaction energy between two stationary polar molecule is proportional to 1 by r to the power 3. And dipole-dipole interaction energy between rotating polar molecules, if it is rotating polar molecules, then it will be 1 by r to the power 6. So r is the distance between polar molecule. Clear? So dipole-dipole interaction is due to which? Polar interaction. Okay, dipole-dipole is polar interaction. Clear? Now, if higher dipole moment indicates, that means charge is high and distance is also high. Okay, so it is more polar, no problem. It is more polar. higher dipole moment is, it is more polar. Clear? Now, dipole induced dipole interaction. Clear? What is this? What happens when a molecule having zero dipole moment comes into contact with molecules having zero dipole moment? Okay. Or amra bolte pari when it comes into high dipole moment, then what happen? What happens when a molecule non zero dipole moment comes into contact with molecule having zero dipole moment? মানে ওই যেটা एग्जांपल দিলাম অরেথিক এবং আমাদের সিজি, তাই তো? এবং সেই সঙ্গে আয়ুষ, এটা কি হচ্ছে, একে অপরের উপরে ডিপেন্ডেন্ট হয়ে যাচ্ছে। হ্যাঁ, দ্যাটস মিন ওয়ান ইজ পোলার, অ্যানাদার ইজ নন পোলার, দেন বিটুইন দিস ইন্টারঅ্যাকশন নন পোলার মলিকুল উইল ইন্ডিউসড, ওকে, সাম হট এক্সটেন্ড অ্যাকচুয়ালি, এন্ড ইট উইল বি polar. That's mean actually it is induced dipole. So this is polar molecule and this is non-polar molecule. Okay, red one is non-polar molecule. Now there is an interaction between polar and non-polar, then this non-polar will be somewhat extend in polar molecules. Okay, so now what happened? When they come close to each other, then this non-polar molecule, surrounded by electron cloud, you know, non-polar molecule, it also contains electrons. Okay, so this positive charge of the polar molecule, attract the electron cloud of the non-polar molecule. Okay, attract the electron of non-polar molecule, then there will be a polarization. This is a polarization. Okay, so shape was spherical, but now it is oval shape. Yes, so there will be a charge, negative, positive. So it was the right one. The right one was the non-polar, but now in presence of polar molecule, it is a polar. Okay, so it is induced dipole. Clear? Now these both are can attract to each other. Okay, non-polar and polar molecule can attract to each other. This is the interaction. So this is dipole and this is induced dipole. Okay, this is induced dipole. Clear? So it is an attraction. That's mean dipole induced dipole interaction. What is this? It is an attraction between polar molecule having permanent dipole moment and a non-polar molecule having zero dipole moment. Yes. So what is this? This is the force of attraction. Okay. So when it is non-polar, then somehow this is non-polar. Now it will convert it to a polar. Okay. In presence of polar molecule. Clear? So it is the attraction between polar molecule having permanent dipole moment and a non-polar molecule having zero dipole moment. Clear? So interaction between, this is the interaction between like benzene and ammonia. Ammonia is polar and benzene is non-polar. This is non-polar. Okay? Benzene is non-polar, ammonia is polar. So attraction between these two molecules, benzene and ammonia, it will be induced dipole interaction. Okay, so dipole induced dipole interaction energy is proportional to 1 by r to the power 6. Okay, this is 1 by r to the power 6. It should be remembered, the dipole induced dipole interaction energy is proportional to what you know already. So which one is the correct? It is r 1 by r to the power 6. Yes,
1 by r to the power 6.
Okay, dipole induced dipole interaction occurs due to the interaction between dipole induced dipole interaction occurs due to interaction between non zero dipole and zero dipole moment. Yes, non zero dipole and zero dipole moment. This is the answer. Then ion dipole interaction. What is ion dipole interaction? If this is a dipole, A is delta positive, B is delta negative, then this is a two poles. This is a two poles. Okay, this is two charge also. So this is polar molecule. This is polar molecule. And now we will take ions. So what is ion? What is ion? You know, ion are charged faces, whereas atoms are electrically neutral. Okay, ions actually charged faces, then na? Whereas atom kintu electrically neutral. So how ions are formed from an atom? You know, gaining the ionization potential or losing electron from atom, it will be cation. That's been ion. So gaining electron, it will be anion. Yes, it will be anion, and losing electron, it will be cation. So now, example that there is Na plus Cl minus in a solution. So Na plus is ion, Cl minus is also ion, and if it is dissolved, that is Na plus Cl minus in aqueous solution. Okay, there is a cation and anion. So many cation and anions in this way. Okay, now this is completely ion, and if we go for water, then water contains dipole. That's it. A is delta plus, O is the delta minus. Okay, like this. So you know already, oxygen is the second most electronegative element in the periodic table. Yes, so oxygen is the second most electronegative element in the periodic table. So it will be delta minus because it will pull the electron towards itself. So it gain partial negative charge. It gains partial negative charge. Clear? Is it okay? So this is a dipole. Now with this dipole, when it attracts ion, so A is delta, A is plus, it attracts Cl minus, and oxygen delta minus attract Na plus. Clear? So this is dipole and this is ion. So there is a ion dipole interaction. Okay, Na plus Cl minus is ion, and water or HCl or like this type of molecule is polar molecule. So ion dipole interaction is occur. Clear? So Na plus is positive charge, you already know, and it can attract so many water molecules like this. Okay, and they can associate with Na plus ion. Okay, so this is known as ion dipole interaction. Is it okay? And Cl minus is also can attract H plus of water, delta H plus. Okay, it can also associate, hence gets attracted to positive end of the solvent molecule, that's mean H plus. So now this can be association. Okay, in this way they can, Cl minus can attract delta H plus of water, and they can associate in this way. So in aqueous solution of sodium chloride, this type of formation we can see, and Cl minus can associated with delta H plus, and Na plus is associated with delta O minus. Okay, so this is the formation. So this phenomenon of oppositely charged ion getting surrounded by the opposite end of the solvent molecule. Okay, clear? This is actually solvation. This is also known as solvation or association of the ions and dipole. Clear? So this solvent is the water. Hair solvent is water, you know. This is also known as hydration. Yes, because water is associated with any positive or negative ion. So it is also known as hydration. Factor affecting ion dipole. Factor affecting ion dipole interaction. Okay, ion dipole interaction. Charge of the ion and size of the ion. Okay, if charge is high, then attraction will be high. Size is small, attraction will be high. Okay, like this. So dipole moment. Dipole moment means, you know already, dipole moment mu equal to charge of any pole into distance between these two pole. Okay, now which one can attract more, Na plus or Mg2 plus? You know, since Mg2 plus is high charge, okay, so which ion will have more attractive power? You already know Mg2 plus because it is high charge. Okay, and why? Because this is the higher charge. Okay, and then high is the attraction. Size of the ion. Okay, if size is low, then so higher among the Na plus and K plus, which is the charge more concentrated? Actually, Na plus. Yes. Why? This is concentrated charge will attract more or a dispersed charge. Okay. Clear? So this is due to the small size. A neutral atom, you know, any atom is always neutral. If it lose electron, then it will be positive, and if it gain electron, it will be negatively charged. It is anion. Okay, so size of the cation is smaller than its parent atom. Always cation is smaller than neutral atom. Anion is more size than its neutral atom. Okay, so size of cation is smaller than its parent atom. Clear? And also size of anion is greater than its parent atom. So which ion will have more attraction towards the opposite side of dipole? Which ion will have more attraction towards opposite side of dipole? Is it cation? Is it anion? This is cation because of the small size. Because from the parent atom, if it is cation, then size will be decreased and it will be concentrated charge. Now, association of sodium plus in water, so this will be high. Okay, hence there is a strong interaction between cation and negative end of solvent molecules. Yes. Now there is a question: which ion will have more attraction power? Na plus, Mg2 plus, or both, or none of these? You already know Mg2 plus is small size and is high charge. Okay, then which ion will have more attraction towards negative side of the dipole? Negative side of the dipole, which one? Which will be some more attraction towards negative side of the dipole? Obviously cation. Okay, this cation. Cation always attract negative side. So non-polar interaction. Non-polar interaction. If there is no polar molecules, but it contains some interaction, this is also known as dispersion forces. This is dispersion forces. Like solid, liquid, and gaseous states exist due to the intermolecular force of attraction. Intermolecular force of attraction. Okay. If it is non-polar, then it also contains some interaction. So why one molecule attract another molecules? Why? You know already the polar molecule always attract polar molecule, or polar molecule can attract also non-polar molecule by induced dipole. But why non-polar molecule attract non-polar molecules? Okay. Why? Charge of dipole if there is a, but when it is induced, okay, then it is also polar non-polar interaction. But when non-polar non-polar interaction occurs, that is non-polar molecules, there is no charge. So non-polar molecules do not have any charge or do not carry charge. Okay. So we should know that it can't attract each other, but how they can attract it by to each other? Okay. So it is known as, according to scientist London, this London, okay, it is known as London force. So London force act on dispersion as a dispersion force between non-polar molecules. Okay. So for any interaction, molecules should have dipole. But now, for any interaction, molecules should have dipole or to be charged. But some non-polar molecule also have some interaction. Clear? This is known as London force. Okay. So they do not have charge. Or non-polar molecule, that they do not carry any charge, they do not have dipole, yes, of course. So they do not have intermolecular force of attraction because it does not have any pole. So non-polar molecule cannot exist as solid and liquid. Always it will exist as gaseous system because they will not attract to each other. So they will not close to each other. If one molecule attract another molecule, they will be closed. But when they are not attracting to each other, so they are not closed. So it is in gaseous system. So non-polar molecule is always in, remains in gaseous system, but still they have some force of attraction. This is known as dispersion forces, and London study this. So for gaseous system, they should have only gas. Okay. Like if it is benzene, what should be the state of matter? Gaseous. But no, benzene is liquid. Okay, benzene is liquid. So how it is possible? Because benzene is non-polar. Benzene is non-polar, but it is liquid. How it is possible? Because there is no dipole-dipole interaction. Carbon tetrachloride is non-polar molecule, but it should have in the gaseous state, but it is liquid. Okay. So how it is possible? No, it is not gas. Okay, so it is liquid. Carbon tetrachloride liquid, benzene is liquid, though they are non-polar. There is no dipole-dipole interaction. So how we can explain this? So non-polar substance, benzene, exists as liquid means they have intermolecular force of attraction. Yes, because they can close enough to be liquid. So generally, non-polar molecule exists in, generally, non-polar molecule exists in gaseous system. Okay, in gaseous system. Okay, dispersion force. Now dispersion force. Dispersion force acts among non-polar molecules. Okay, how they can create? That's mean actually dipole created dipole interaction. It is non-polar, but one non-polar molecule when attract another non-polar molecule, that's mean they create a pole. Because in, you know, in every shell contains electron of any atom. Okay, they can revolving. So when another molecules comes close to each other, then its positive nucleus attract the electron density of the another molecules. Then a dipole create. So polar molecule can attract also non-polar molecule. Okay, so this is the induced dipole or disperse or dipole created dipole moment. Okay, so a non-polar molecule having zero dipole moment, but if there is a polar molecule, they can attract this non-polar molecule because it contains electron. Okay, so instead they can attract. So there is an instantaneous dipole moment. So this is known as dispersion force. So this dipole created dipole moment like this. Okay, dipole created dipole moment like this. Okay, electron density somewhat in the left hand side or right hand side, on upper side or lower side. In this way, electron revolving and instantaneous. There is a force of attraction. So charges are continuously fluctuating. Charges are continuously fluctuating for non-polar molecules. For this reason, any other polar molecules can attract this type of molecule because there is electron density. So symmetrical distribution of electron occur. So due to the constant motion of electron, an atom or molecule act as a temporary dipole, that is non-zero dipole moment. Okay, it can attract. So unsymmetrical distribution, this is unsymmetrical distribution, this is symmetrical distribution. Then if you see that for unsymmetrical distribution of electron, if electron is in the right hand side and electron is left hand side, then this will be plus. Okay, and it is negative, then it will be plus. Then another molecule can attract to each other. Okay, so due to this second atom, it turns distorted, which leads to an electrostatic attraction between two atoms. Okay, like this. So this is a dipole created dipole. This is dipole created dipole. This is known as London force. Any problem? This is dispersion force also. This London force is also known as dispersion force. So it is the attraction between two temporary dipole. It is not permanent dipole. Yes, it is temporary dipole because electron is revolving. Electron is revolving. This electron, while it comes to this position, then this attraction will be low. Okay, again this electron revolving in this way, and sometimes it create dipole, again it's remove dipole. So there is a some attraction. So it is the attraction between two temporary dipoles of atom or non-polar molecules. Okay, so factor affecting dispersion forces: size of atom or molecules. What is the size of atoms? If it is hard molecule or atom, that's mean if its size is small or high. Okay, so size increase, that's mean distance between nucleus and electron will be increased, then polarization increase, that's mean it will be more attracted by the other polar molecules. Okay, so size is increased, hence distance between nucleus and valence electron will be increased. Okay, this distance, if distance is high, then polarization will be high. That's mean dipole create or creation of dipole will be high. Okay, so this will be dipole, then they can attract, so easily pull the electron of the outermost shell, they can pull. Okay, that's mean disturb. This is nonpolar, completely nonpolar, but when this pole attract this electron, then it will be polar or it will be distorted. Okay, then it will be polar, and bigger size of the molecule, easily the molecule can be polarized. Polarized means electron density will be like this, exposed towards the positive charge. Okay, this is, so that was the spherical, but now this is electron density will be move towards the positive charge. So this is dipole created dipole or dispersion force. And fluidity, that is ability to flow. Fluidity means ability to flow. That's when gaseous system always flow, you know, gaseous system always flow. So fluidity means ability to flow. Okay, compressibility, ability to get compressed. Okay, so polarizability, ability to get polarized. So that's mean distortion,